I've had the opportunity to interview a lot of different persons for their role as a business controller. And in that interview, I always added an Excel test, and we will go through that Excel test in this video, where you hopefully can learn something along the way and also see what bad mistakes that the candidates did, in my opinion. Here is the Excel file with all the questions. It's 5 questions. And the first question, I wanted the candidate to get the budget for June for all accounts. And you find the budget in the sheet budget. Down here, we have the budget sheet. Here is all the budgets, and you have the cost centers here. And you can see that there are multiple accounts for the same cost center, and I wanted them to retrieve all the budget for all accounts for that cost center for this month. And there are different ways to accomplish this. For example, you could do a pivot table and just add the cost center and then June and then the value. That's one very good solution. What's not a good solution is to use a lookup function like XLOOKUP, IndexMatch, VLOOKUP, or anything like that, because that will only retrieve the first value that you match with and not sum all the accounts for that cost center. Instead, what I thought of when I did this test was that the candidate should use the SUMIFS or SUMIF function. Go to the budget sheet, select the June month, that's the sum range, and the cost center will be our criteria range if it matches with our cost center. And we don't need to make these absolute when we have the entire column, and this one will only go downwards, so that is also all right to do. Moving on to the second question is, I wanted them to make a line chart showing the trend for account 3500 and the cost center 105. The same data here from the budget sheet, and I also wanted them to place it in this sheet. I definitely thought that this was the easiest task that I've given them, but I had so much wrong there. They tried to do everything, but not what they should have done. The line chart should be this line here, the cost center 105 and the account 3500, and it trend over the entire year. One way to do it is to just select the cells, go to the insert tab, and create a line chart here. But then you need to filter all that we do not want here, for example, like this. Another way is to just simply select the two arrays with the control button, head over to the insert tab, and then insert a line chart. And that's a much quicker way to do it. And then control X to cut it out and control V to paste it into this sheet. This should have taken just a couple of seconds for the candidates, but they struggled a lot. So it was a good idea for me to add it into this interview. Moving on to the third question is a question where we have amounts in different currencies, and I wanted them to convert it into Swedish crowns. Also here, there are multiple ways to accomplish this task. You could use the IFS function. First, you take the amount and then you divide it with an IFS. But the best way that I say is to use an XLOOKUP function for the Danish crowns here. In this array here, lock them with F4 and then return this value here. And before that, we pick our amount and multiply it. Then you get the same result, but it's much quicker and easier to use a lookup function and just look through the array and then retrieve the value underneath. In this task, a lot of candidates didn't know how to apply the absolute and relative references with the F4 key, And that is very important. For example, if you do not select the entire row or the entire column, then you need to make sure that you lock those references. Moving on to the fourth question, it is just a simple lookup function where I want to retrieve, get the price of the currencies below. Here we have the currencies. They are also in this tab sheet here. We have the currencies and we have the price. I just wanted them to use an XLOOKUP, VLOOKUP, or an index match function. XLOOKUP, of course, is the best way to do it because it's so easy. And here you have it, and just copy it down and you're finished in just a couple of seconds. This is to see if you know a very basic lookup function in Excel. The fifth and final question is, of course, the most difficult one. Here we have two different parameters, and we want to get the result for that cost center and that month from this sheet here. In this case, it's June 127. We have 127 and June. We want to retrieve this value here. To do this, you need to match on both the row and the column in order to get what's in the matrix. You can do this in different ways, as always, but the most efficient way is to use either the index match or the XLOOKUP. And XLOOKUP is quite new, so I will show you that one in this video. Let's go to result and use our XLOOKUP function, where our lookup value will be the cost center. Lookup array will be the cost center here. Make sure we lock it. And our return array will be another XLOOKUP function where we now look after the month. And the lookup array will be the months up here. Lock them, and then our return array will be our cells here. Also lock them, and we close the second XLOOKUP function, and we close the first XLOOKUP function. And here you have the values. You could, of course, use the index match function where you nest two match functions within the index function. It takes about the same time. It's almost as easy, but this is a new way to do it. And that's what I wanted to show to you in this video. I'd say that about 10% of all the candidates know how to retrieve, get a value from a matrix using the XLOOKUP or the index match function. But there is quite a lot of different situations when you work with a lot of data when you need to know this. Hopefully you learn something along the way. If you want to learn even more in Excel and enjoy this content, subscribe if you want to get even more like this.